Hallelujah. I just want to thank the Lord for this precious moment. Father, I thank you. I bless your holy name. I welcome the Holy Spirit. We all know that the Holy Spirit is inside of us. Mm-hmm. And I want to welcome the Holy Spirit. Take control and use me for your glory. Give me utterance in the name of Jesus. Grant me access to the spirit of understanding, the spirit of knowledge, that I might communicate your word, your counsel to your people in the name of Jesus. I pray, amen.
Amen.
Like most of you know, or everybody know, my name is Dorina Alimenda. Originally from the Caribbean, there is a country right above Brazil called Suriname. I have three amazing boys, Sabah, Sadrak, and Israel, and I've been married for 29 years. My husband, amazing man, humble man, and I thank God for his life. I have also three grandchildren, and I'm blessed. And what brought me to the United States is my ministry, my ordination. And I want to die empty. I don't want to go with what God put inside of me to the grave. I just want to impact my goal. That's why I'm here. And I just want to thank Sister Terry for this conference that keep us together so I can share my mind. And I believe one person's life will change. And like we all know, the topic is love one another. I just want to talk general, and I just want to start with this. We all know that a component of man is in three parts: the soul, spirit, soul, and body. And we know that when you're born again, everything that you need is inside of your spirit. You have healing, you have prosperity, anything you need is in your spirit. But for you to benefit from those things, you need to work on it. You need to work on them, you need to labor, and you need the grace to labor to put them on your soul. Otherwise, you will keep saying you are Christian, you are born again. Well, you are Christian because if Jesus told you to go to heaven, but you will not enjoy the life on this planet. So for you to enjoy the life, you have to make sure you put what you have in the spirit onto your soul. And then the scripture, the Bible said in Ephesians 2, verse 5 and 6, it said, we are sitting with Christ in heavenly places. That part that sitting with Christ in heavenly places is not your body or soul. It's your spirit dimension. Meaning, actually we use the word you rapture already. Your soul is here, your body is here, but you rapture already because your spirit is with God, with Jesus Christ, mingled together. So we have everything inside there. And in 2 Peter 1:3, it said that you have everything to live on this planet, godly and to pertain to life. I just paraphrased the whole scripture. And like we know, the topic of tonight, love one another. What is love? According to the definition, love is an action word. You do something. And what is walking in love? We're going to read that from the book of Ephesians 4, verse 1 to 3. If you read the whole Bible of the whole book of Ephesians 1 to 3, you will see that it's everything that Jesus done for us on the mountain. He died for us. Just brought us to heaven. Our spirit, of course. But from 4 to 6, you need to do something. So even though we're born again, we have everything inside of our spirit, you have to walk on them. So my question is, what is walking in love? Because it is a doing thing. It's something that you do. So then we're going to read from Ephesians 4, verse 1 to 3. And you know me. Please. Yes, 4, verse 1 to
3. 4, 1 to 3?
Yes. No, verse 1 to 3.
4:1-3. As a prisoner for the Lord, then I urge you to live a life worthy of calling you have received. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. were called, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all.
Okay, thank you. Actually, what I wanted to tap on is the love part. I think I have another translation. So, anyway, if we go to this scripture, then you will see what is love. Like I said, love is a born word. So love is what God told you to do that you are doing. That is love. Love is what God called you to do. Sometimes what we call love, you know, love me please for tonight, let me say it. Sometimes it's pretend. We don't really love. We pretend most of the time that we love each other. But the real love that God is talking about, the Bible is talking about, is the agape love. You love anyway, because love is must, but the relationship is a choice. You can choose to be close to me, but love you, you need to love me. And how are we going to do that? We don't abide. You know, sometimes we talk things that we are thinking maybe is good news. It's not good news, but did you hear what happened with that one? She's going through this one. It's not because you care. It's because you find something to talk about a person. And then we are saying we are Christian. But that's not really what the Bible is talking about. If you read Ephesians 4, when Paul wrote this book to the Ephesian people, love is an action word. And if you love somebody, you will never hurt the person. Mm-hmm. You love the person, you will not backbite the person. You love someone, you will help. You might not every time, but at least the compassion will be there. Yeah. You see, you show say, well, I wish I could, you know, but this is my idea about what you just asked or about what you are going through. You see, and those are the things that God wants from us. You see, we if people don't see Christ in the Bible, it's not your fault. But if they don't see Christ in our life, we cannot show Christ, that is our fault. So we have to really work on ourselves, especially the soul part, because your soul is your personality. So you have to bring Christ to your soul. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to tell people, I'm born again or I'm a Christian. The way you walk, the way you talk, the way you dress. Sometimes people say your dressing doesn't matter, but it matters. Because the Bible says even the hair on your head is counted. Why is God go and just count the small thing? And how you dress is not important. You know, of course, you don't have to dress the way someone is dressing, but at least let people see you and say, she's a child of God. You know, the way you talk, the way you do. Even in making jokes, it's really important how we do the jokes. Yes. Because at the end of the day, you know, it's God, creation is there, your sister, your brother, you know. And one part in the Bible said, how can you love God that you don't see? No, you don't love your sister that you see or your brother, but you say you love God. That part of this scripture. So we have to first love your brother and sister. And then